Hi, this is Zamboni from the Cloudy Night Forums with a video on processing moon images. I already have a picture opened up in Adobe Photoshop in Camera Raw showing a single sub-exposure of the moon. This was taken on October 23rd, and it was taken with my Canon XSI. Modified, and I also had a light pollution filter attached to it, and the camera was attached to my Celestron C6N, which is 750 millimeter focal length telescope that is at f5. You may be wondering why the moon isn't quite as bright as it was in the sky, but I've found in my processing that it's actually a little bit best to have the moon right about in the middle of the histogram. The reason for this is that the moon is quite bright, and you can very easily clip the brighter portions of the craters, and putting it in the middle of the histogram gives you a little bit of leeway in stretching and to, you know, add contrast to your image. And while you're doing your processing, you don't actually clip the higher values. It gives you a little bit more room to do a little bit more processing without ruining the images. I mean, the dynamic range and all the other stuff. Plus, I found it's a little bit easier to add contrast. If everything's higher in the dynamic range or on the histogram, it's very hard to separate some of these rays from these not quite so bright regions in the moon. As you can see here in this image, there is quite a bit of detail in the image, but we can make it better. We can get it smoother, add a little bit more detail through some deconvolution techniques, and add a little bit of color with saturation adjustments. One thing you might notice if you zoom in on some of the darker spaces, it's a little bit noisy. One way to help improve the signal-to-noise ratio with images is to actually stack several different pictures. Doing this, it increases the signal-to-noise ratio and allows you to push sharpening and deconvolution a little bit further than you could on single images. And the proof is in the pudding. You should see. You will see at the end when you see the final image. I originally shot 62 separate subframes, but for the sake of this tutorial, I'm only going to stack about 10 of them. This gives you an idea of what I've done without, you know, having a lot of processing time taken up in the video. First thing I'm going to do, I close that. I'll open up the 10 images of the moon, the raw images of the moon. These will open up in Camera Raw, and as you can see from this, there's a lot of empty space. Opening it up in some of the programs, you know, it's going to take a long time to do that, so let's crop the images just a little bit to get rid of a lot of that empty space and help the processing go on along a little bit faster. As you can see here, I've got the moon in that position. Let's just see where it is a little bit later on. It's moved over a little bit. Even on a tracking platform, the moon doesn't, you know, go by the Earth's rotation. It's a little bit slower than the Earth, so it moves a little bit even with the tracking platform. So let's crop off a bit of the black area here. So I'm going to select all of the frames and then go up to the cropping tool and then crop right around the moon. Oh, looks like I might have gone a little bit too far over on this first image, so I'll just move over a little bit more. And I just want to make sure in all of these that the moon is not clipped on the side. That looks good. And what I do here is I actually save the images as TIFF files. And here I'll just save, select a new folder. Make new folder. New folder. Just change it to. Come on. Rename to crop. Select. And here we've got the name. Full moon. Cuteness starting at 0. Extension as a TIFF. No compression, and hit save. And you see, it's right through, the 9 remaining, and I'm going to pause it here while it goes through. Okay, now, Camera Raw has finished saving the files, so now we have a cropped images of the moon. We've got 10 of them. Now we're going to go to the initial alignment for stacking. Here, I'm going to exit out of Photoshop and now open up Registax. Registax is a great program for processing moon, sun, and planetary videos. It helps line and stack those and help get sharp images out of what kind of looks kind of muddy on the screen when capturing. Okay, I'm going to go back to the file, the folder where I saved the files, crop folder, and now we have our 10 images that were saved. I'll just go ahead, copy them, and just drag them right straight into Registax. Registax has its own way of, it can align and track images, but because I took these images of the moon in between clouds, there's a little bit of a jump, and Registax does not like a lot of jumping around because it's hard to track on that. So I'm going to do an initial alignment by hand. This is kind of easy because you can see this is the first image, go to the second image, there's quite a bit of jump. Third image, it moves a little bit more. So on here, I'm going to choose, go back to the first image, an alignment box size of 128. I'm going to choose align the images manually and then click on a bright kind of contrasty alignment feature, and I'm going to go right here. And then I do that for the first one. It doesn't really look like it's taking that. Okay, there it goes. Then I hit align. And it's going to ask me to point at the same alignment feature and left click on it. So go here, click. Moves over, click, click, click. And just continue for all 10. And its alignment's finished. So I go through that, and now I limit the number of frames. Because I'm just doing the initial alignment, I'm just going to choose all of the frames here. Go down to this bottom slider, that's where you choose, it's all the way over here. I'm going to go through and make sure it covers all 10. Stack size 10 out of 10. Hit the limit. And here is where it takes that initial alignment and kind of optimizes. I'm going to go ahead and optimize it. And that's what it shows here. It did a 10, all 10 frames, optimized it really quick. And I'm not going to fully go through with the stack, because this is just a single alignment point. I'm going to want to go back and do a multi-point alignment. This here will choose several different spots across the moon and do an alignment on each of that, take and stack, and provide a composite picture out of that. But for this initial alignment, there's a nifty little feature that in the latest Registax is this create AVI option. What I do to come back, I actually don't make an AVI out of it. I go back and select PNG. This will save each of these frames as a 16-bit PNG file. I don't want to choose alignment area, because that will only choose that small little 128 box. I want to go to the maximum area and then hit save registered. So it'll save each of these as a PNG file registered on this single alignment point. I'll go ahead and hit that. And it'll take about a minute or two to finish. And I'll pause this while it's going through, and I'll catch you on the back end.